work hard. Shirley, Frimpong, Manso. Fantastic to have you here.
Yes, I love it. I love you here.
Okay. Well, it's good to have you here.
Thank you.
I'm glad I'm the first one to interview you.
Yes, you're my first.
So, 10 years down the road, perfect picture.
Yep.
Did you imagine this day?
Did I?
Let's say 15 years ago, did you see today?
No, I did not.
Tell us about the journey between number one and number two.
Okay, well, it's been quite a journey, to be honest. Started making movies around 2007.
Okay.
Our very first was Life and Living It.
Okay.
Yes. And at the time, there were no cinemas. There was no Silver Bed or anything. Yeah. So we actually premiered at National Theatre. Mm. I think we showed it a few times.
Okay.
And the response was very good. It was very, very good. And then we went on to do Scorned, which was our second.
Yeah.
So after Scorned, we thought, you know, why don't we do something fun, colorful, you know, more Ghanaian. In saying Ghanaian, meaning using more Ghanaian music, you know, in that way. And I remember when we were editing, we were almost done editing. The thing is, we had so much fun shooting that movie.
Mm.
We had so much fun in post-production. We honestly didn't care if people liked it or not, because we loved it.
Yeah.
You know, we had such a good time doing it.
Yeah.
And then I remember we went to Silver Bed at the time because they had just opened.
Started, yeah.
And they were doing all these Hollywood movies. And then we went and said, we have this movie that we would like to show in the cinema. And the person there at the time said, I'm sorry, we're not doing Ghanaian movies yet. And, you know, we're very, very disappointed. Mm. So we said, okay, we're going to go ahead and do our showing at National Theatre.
Yeah.
And I remember on that day, it was a Friday, around 4 o'clock, we were called that our tickets were finished.
Okay.
You know, and we're thinking, well, this is good.
Mm-hmm.
The first showing was around 6 o'clock. It was packed. I mean, it was full.
You didn't imagine that would happen.
No. So, yeah, everything was coming so very quickly, you know. Yeah. Yes. And so when the first showing was about to end, I was in the hall when somebody called and said, you need to come outside and see something. I walked out into the foyer.
Yeah.
And behind the glass, you know, because they were not allowing the second showing patrons to come in yet.
Okay.
There were people everywhere.
Wow.
And people were pressed against the glass.
Oh my goodness.
It was crazy.
Oh my goodness.
I just stood there and I was like, what is going on?
Wow.
And then you could hear people say, Shirley, I've got my ticket. You know, the frenzy at that time was, if we don't watch this movie now, we're not going to get a chance to watch it because, you know, it wasn't going to show anywhere. It wasn't going to show a Silver Bed or anything. Yes. Yeah. And it was crazy. I got calls. People said, look, I have parked my car like, you know, I'm walking.
Yeah.
It was crazy. And then they won't allow the patrons from the first showing to go out.
Okay.
So then they forced themselves in.
Oh, no.
The place was packed. It was chaotic. People were sitting. We said, you can't sit on the floor. I'll sit on the floor. People were sitting on the floor, standing. We went ahead to do two more showings when we didn't really plan for it. It was crazy.
Wow.
The next day, we got a call from Silver Bed saying that, bring the movie. So that's how it all started. We took it to the cinemas, and for 6 weeks straight, it was packed every day.
Hmm.
So I guess, you know, we call it the revival of sorts, you know.
Yeah.
The Perfect Picture was the movie that revived
interest
in Ghanaian movies, you know, yes.
How did it make you feel to have been at the fulcrum of that activity?
You know, when it's happening, you don't see it.
Mm.
It's actually much, much later, and this would be many years later. I feel proud, you know, sometimes very emotional, because 10 years after all of that, I would have expected that the Ghana movie industry would have, you know, gone much further than where we are today.
Yeah.
Sadly, it almost feels like we have gone back.
Retrogressed?
Yeah, we have retrogressed where we should have progressed.
What do you think accounts for that, though?
It's policy.
Mm.
It's basically an industry that has no support, you know, from everywhere, you know, and movie making is very expensive, okay, and a lot of Ghanaian producers will tell you they use their own monies,
yeah,
you know, to do the movies,
yeah,
and so how much can you lose, you know, if there's no support system, you know, we still have Silver Bed, but that's just it. We don't have any more cinemas in the regions. Yeah. There's no policy to protect us from all the influx of foreign content that is coming in.
Yeah.
It has just gone from bad to worse.
Coming to the new movie, the 10 years after Perfect Picture, what can patrons expect? Or you're going to keep it under wraps?
Oh, no. I'm going to tease them a little.
Okay, tease us.
Okay, so obviously people are very, very familiar with the characters from 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And we're bringing these characters back,
okay,
and most of them.
Okay.
And then we also have new characters.
Okay.
You know, we do have some Nigerian actors, RMD.
Mm-hmm.
We have Beverly Naya. We have Gideon Okeke.
Okay.
You know, for us, Sparrow, we are looking at the bigger picture now. We're not just looking at making Ghanaian movies.
Mm.
We want to embody what an African story is.
Okay.
You know, so we're spreading our wings.
Mm.
So there are all these very exciting people. Then of course we have Gloria Safo. Then we have a young guy that has been working with us for many years, and this would be his
first movie.
His first big movie. Okay. Yes, because we've used him in other little roles. Okay. Yes, and so he's very excited. I have to also mention,
is it the Osofo?
No, not
okay.
Andrew.
Okay.
Ralph.
Okay.
I'm talking about Ralph.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Young guy, uh-huh, you know, very promising, mm, with a lot of energy and
okay
skill. Yes. So the story in itself is very, engaging.
Mm.
I think I can say very confidently that there's a story in there for everybody.
Okay.
Yourself, myself. Are you married?
Yes.
Okay, good. Yeah. So there's a story in there for married young, you know, people like yourself.
Yeah.
And, you know, there's also stories for, you know, friendship, as in female, you know, in that order. We also have stories that is, we have themes that are bordering on religion.
Okay.
Okay, you know, because as an African society, we're very religious,
you
know, and so we want to see how we can integrate our Christianity and our everyday lives. You know, that's where the Osofo and the things come in. But I'm also very proud to say that we have even committed a lot more time to putting a lot more Ghanaian in the movie.
Okay.
So you have a lot of Ghanaian songs.
Okay.
We work with a lot of Ghanaian designers. In fact, most of the designs that you see in the Perfect Picture have been made by Ghanaian designers who were chosen very carefully by Blisco.
Okay.
Who is our sponsor? Yeah.
I see.
So you will see all of these things, and then the locations are amazing. I mean, you wouldn't believe some of the locations that we found, you know, to use in this movie.
Okay.
People will just
in Ghana. Okay.
People will just be amazed.
Yeah.
You know, we didn't only shoot in Accra. We shot in Ebree. We shot in the Volta region.
Okay.
It was just amazing. Yes.
So, tell me, did you study any part of the filmmaking process before you started doing movies?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
I did. I studied film directing in NAFTI.
Okay.
Yes. But, you know, it doesn't really take the academic work. It also takes the passion and the interest.
Which is what I'm interested in.
Yes.
Because there are a ton of people who have been through the same NAFTI that you went through and haven't necessarily brought anything out, you know.
Yeah.
Not even to say to the standard of what you've done, but nothing at all has come out of it. What is it that drives you to create what you do on a day, you know, every year, something fantastic that you create? What is it that drives you?
It's telling the African story from a very unique point, you know. I know the kind of stories that have been told about the continent, Africa, and especially African women. You know, it almost seems like in these parts, you know, it's gloom. You understand? Yeah. So you see disease, you see dirty gutters, you see poverty. Yes. You know, yes. And right from beginning, I said I wanted to tell a different kind of story.
Okay.
And so it's actually what drives me. And I am also I'm also very concerned about the African young woman.
Okay.
You know, because growing up, I grew up you know, watching my aunties and my mom, and these were very strong African women. But on the screen, what I was watching was the opposite.
A different portrayal.
You know, yes. Yeah. The portrayal was, you know, very weak. You know, at the mercy of, you know, a man.
Yes.
Or, you know, and stuff. Yes. Like that. So the picture is, you know, an African woman, a lot of kids, you know, perhaps no proper jobs, and just at the mercy of everybody.
Yeah.
The in-laws, the this and that. Yeah. And I wanted to change that narrative. And so for me, it is actually what drives me. Okay. And then apart from everything else, I like the idea of creating a story that people watch at the end of the day, and it sort of starts a conversation.
Yeah.
You know, yes. Because we do have a lot of stories in our society, but it's the way it's told, you know, that goes on to do something. And when I meet people who say, oh my God, I love your movies, and I remember this and this happened, and, you know, I was able to relate to it. I met a young guy who said, I started watching your movies when I was very young. I've grown up with that mindset, you know, and the way I see, you know, even my girlfriend and my mother is very different because of your movies. For me, it's you know, it's amazing. Yes. Okay.
So how is it important for us to own our own story, own the narrative, you know, and change the way we portray these things? Because I mean, I'm a photographer, and one of the things that it's burdensome on my heart is imagery. Pictures are everything. You know, and I can stand somewhere, take a picture of something, and somebody else will come and take a picture of the same thing. They'll tell different stories, but we're all there taking pictures of the same scene.
Exactly.
You know, but depending on how your eye sees things, you portray it in a certain way. How important is it for us, you know, all of us, to own our story and to show our story in a certain light?
So let me start off by saying that America is America because of Hollywood.
Okay.
In a lot of the American movies, Hollywood movies, the American president is the most powerful man on earth.
Yeah.
You see the way they guard him. Yeah. You see the way they run around the Air Force One, you know. And then you see, I mean, I grew up thinking that once you get into America, it's probably the streets are paved with gold.
Yeah,
you continue to hear the American dream, and you can do anything if you get into that country. It's exactly what you're saying. It's a narrative. How do you steer people in that direction?
Yeah.
It is very, very important that we first acknowledge that, you know, there are a lot of big rats in New York.
Okay.
As well as there are in...
I've heard of those.
Exactly.
I've heard of those.
You understand? Yeah. Yes. And so...
The sewers.
Exactly. You know, yes. And so it really comes down to what it, how you portray it.
Yeah.
You understand? You could take our Choco, and you could take our Numa, and basically romanticize it in a way that somebody who's sitting somewhere will know that, okay, these are the slums, but, you know, life happens here. You know, the women are strong, they are determined, the men are respectful, they are supportive. You understand? So it is really important that we tell our own story. If we leave it for somebody else to come in and tell it for us, then that's what you get when you usually watch all these international networks. You understand? Yes.
Yeah.
And that is why it is sad that we are not creating enough of these stories. I watched The Crown. It's a British series.
Yes.
And I saw there was a part where, you know, they were portraying Nkrumah. you know, when Nkrumah went to see the queen at the time, and then the queen came into Ghana and all of that. And I immediately Googled the actor, and he's not Ghanaian. He's a British actor.
Okay.
Okay, yes. And I saw how, I saw the portrayal of, you know, what it was, you know, how perhaps they had used our King Tay and all of that stuff. And you could immediately tell that there was something missing. You know, there was something missing from it.
The person doesn't have the authentic experience.
Exactly. You know, and they did not shoot it in Ghana. They shot it in South Africa. You understand? So how about making our this place conducive enough for our stories to be told in the way that we want it to be told? Why aren't they using Ghanaian actors to portray Nkrumah? You understand? It's because we just don't have it. And until we start creating our own and letting people understand that, look, it is possible, yes, to take our stories and make it into something because we understand it better. We should be the consultants of our story. You know, I mean, right now, a lot of the networks, a lot of the international networks are creating content. Very soon, the Sonys and the Netflix are going to come in here and tell our stories for us. The Yas and Twers and then, you know, the Osetutus and stuff. And this is what's going to happen, you know, and we're just going to sit back and cry about it.
Well,
but then what are we doing about it?
Because people like you are here and you're helping
we need
us
the support.
To make that happen.
Yeah. It takes a lot, you know, to make a movie, and especially to make a movie, you know, going back in the day and be, you know, production value and all of that. It takes a lot. Yes.
So the premiere, when?
We're coming back to. Okay, so we're doing an exclusive premiere, which is on Sunday, the 1st of December.
Okay.
We're doing it at Labadi Beach Hotel.
Okay.
Okay. These are for people in the media, and then our sponsors and some stakeholders and some friends. And then, of course, we have indicated that if you must be there, there's a number you can call, and then we'll see how we can help. So that's the premiere. We're calling it the world premiere because it's the first. First time you're going to see it. And then, of course, on the 14th of December, it goes into Silver Bear Cinemas.
Okay.
And then, you know, everybody gets a chance to see it. And then we have the regional showings as well. We're going all around
this
the country.
Nice.
We're going to go to Kumasi, Takrade, Sunyai, Kufodia, you know. So everybody will get a chance to see it. And then, of course, we're looking to do the international showings as well.
Okay.
London. Yeah, nice. We're looking to go into cinemas in London.
This is good.
Yes, Toronto and, of course, America.
You're leaving no stone unturned.
No, we're not. Because we know we've got a good product and we want the world to see it. Yes.
Absolutely. All right. So we've been speaking with Shirley Frimpong-Manso, and she's telling us about a little bit about her work life. And one day we need to get you back for a longer interview.
Yes.
Yes.
I have a lot to say.
Okay. Good. Good. So we'll get you back.
All right.
Yeah. So, and the premiere is coming on 1st of December. And of course, there'll be the 14th as well, and then other ones. So thank you very much to you, Shirley.
Thank you for having
thank you
me.
For having. And Adams Apple, I'm wondering when you're going to do something.
Oh, something is
something.
Coming.
Okay,
fantastic. I've said it here first.
let's take a look at the trailer for the 10 years after Perfect Picture.
10 years ago, I had the call to fix a broken air condition in the office of the most beautiful woman I had ever seen.
We have to celebrate every anniversary with the same old love story every year.
Life just be pot of beans, Charlie. Every day we wake up, we de grind, we de ball.
No, I am not sick. I am bored.
All right. Then let me relax you.
No, no.
What's wrong?
Why did our life become so complicated?
Growing up sucks.
When's the last time any of you prayed?
Hello, Dede.
Hello, Reverend.
You know, as human beings, we hide a lot from the world.
I didn't know we were talking about my past. Besides, I never asked you about yours.
And you're perfectly okay with not knowing anything about my past?
You are my husband's lover. You have to tell me everything. And when I say that, I mean everything.
Get out! Do you know it's criminal to share videos like this? Do you understand?
So this is raping a 21-year-old.
What did you say?
Why are we in debt?
I realize how much I've messed up, and I swear to you, I will fix it on my life.
Nigerian?
I can find you work. A brand new car, accommodation, a salary advance of up to $150,000.
You want me to have an abortion?
Where have you been?
He's a little perfect, isn't he? There is no such thing as a perfect man.
From Ghana, we have Shirley Frimpong Manso and the whole Sparrow team here. They have been nominated in about four or five categories.
Yes, about five categories, yes.
Mm. And I'm sure you're very hopeful.
Well, we're hopeful. Mm. We did a good job, you know. Yeah, myself and my fellow producers. This is Ken, Inya. Mm-hmm. Yes, so we're hopeful.
Mm. How many of them do you hope to pick?
At least one.
And at most everything. Why not?
Yeah. I'll go with her. At least one. Okay. So he wants more then.
Yes.
Now, but this is a great opportunity for us to sell what we do in Ghana to
yes.
the world.
Yes.
What do you make of this initiative?
I think it's great. I mean, this is about the third time we're coming, or fourth. The fourth time we're coming, yes.
How many and have you won so far, ever since we began?
Several.
Okay.
Several.
Okay.
Yes, we have. You know, and every year I think that it's an opportunity to, like you said, be able to sell ourselves and our country and what it is that we do. You know, Potato Potato was a collaboration, you know, Ghanaian and Nigerian. And for us, I think the collaboration was also very good because it took us very far. You know, yeah, we didn't just... We're not just selling Ghana, but we're selling Africa. But apart from everything else, the movie was shot in Ghana. We're able to showcase, again, you know, what it is that we have, you know, yes. And I just hope that we take a cue, the country takes a cue from all of this and supports the industry, those who can, you know, and let's take it to the next level.
Now that you've talked about support, there was a story that broke a lot of hearts in Ghana, where you said you're almost at the verge of laying your tools.
Yes, I was emotional. Mm. My manager, Inya, she says I shouldn't say that again.
Yeah, I think a lot of Ghanaians will be heartbroken if you do that.
I don't know. Sometimes it's you know, it gets really difficult, you know, it gets really tough. And then you're thinking, what am I doing all of this for? Especially when you almost feel like you're not getting the support, especially from your own place. So yeah, that's basically it. But look, I love what I do. And I think no matter where I find myself, I'll continue to do it.
Ken, let me just move here and speak to you briefly. Now, you've been supporting, I don't know, maybe you are not even supporting, maybe you are the main man, we don't know. So I don't know how to put it. But, you know, and this is the journey so far. Like, she's talked about the challenges she's been through. Maybe you have never spoken, so we don't know if you also, you know, face similar challenges, like, with her. Because well, the team works.
Well, it's the same, really. Mm-hmm. The support comes in, and together we're able to create the content that we create. We really need our governments, you know, stakeholders, to really consider what it is that we're doing, and to help us form proper systems so that we can continue to do this. Look, there's so much we can do if we're able to put the type of things that we do, the type of movies, the type of series that we do, we're able to put it on the map. We can go really, really far with getting our country exposed to the world. So we need that support. We do. The challenges are there, but we will work with those who are interested in helping us, curb those challenges.
You're Nigerian, right?
Yes, I am.
So just putting you on the spot, you came together with a team to produce this. What triggered that?
Well, we've known each other for a while, and like Shirley said, I manage her as well. So it was just, it was a no-brainer, really.
Mm.
I think, I don't know about others, the Ghanaians I know are very fantastic. These people mean the world to me.
Wow.
And there are a few Nigerians and a few Ghanaians in the mix. Just this is just three of us, you know, in the mix as well. So
are you looking forward to so many more collaborations?
We're definitely doing more. Mm. We're definitely, for sure, doing more. So like she said, I mean, we need support. From Nigeria, we need support. From Ghana, we need support. We need support everywhere so we can do more of these collaborations together.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much for speaking to us. Enjoy yourself in there.